know, math needs to be engaging. It's a subject that portrays the patterns of life. So I like to bring in really fun activities for students, like zip lines. All of those things bring math alive in the real world, and it makes it exciting and applicable for students. A modern math classroom is where the students are doing most of the talking. It's not where I'm the sage on the stage. My class is really student-centered, where students are doing the talking, and I rely heavily on group work.
She is all about creating lessons that engage her students, connect it to the real world, and show them that math is not procedural, it's beautiful.
When I go into Kristan Morales' classroom, I see student engagement, teacher-student connection, and the use of a lot of instructional strategies.
When she talks about growth mindset, she talks about encouraging us and not putting us in like a bad place and like thinking we can't do anything.
You know that you can achieve anything at high levels if you persevere and put in the hard work. So students see themselves as having the opportunity and ability to achieve math at really high levels. So when the pandemic hit, as we found ourselves in the midst of teaching online, I found an opportunity for a renaissance in education and created an opportunity for teachers to do things they never thought was previously possible in their classroom.
When we built a list of people that we can leverage their knowledge and their skill sets, Kristan was near the top of that list.
She was there, she was supporting me. In turn, I would turn around and help my other members of my department.
You know, the pandemic obviously had a challenging impact. Kristan immediately, I know, was thrust into action, and as far as providing multiple instructional strategies and technology tools.
I don't use technology for technology's sake, because I'm always trying to create new, fun, engaging lessons for students and 21st century learning.
Ms. Morales shared with me about ESports and Super Smash Brothers, and I really didn't know much about it.
So in our Super Smash Bros. Club meetings, we started having small tournaments just in our classroom, and so it started at just a very small level.
Joining the club, I figured out, wow, you know, there's a lot of people who enjoy the game, you know, like me. So I definitely felt a bit more accepted from there.
If there was no Super Smash Bros. Club, I feel like there'd be a lack of community, because I've seen a lot of other people from our club go to other clubs like Anime Club, so I feel like there's a lot of overlap and people you could meet and be friends with.
She opens up her classroom, invites students in there. It just gives them a safe place to really enjoy something that they love, and I think that kind of supersedes just even anything about the content of it.
Esports really provides something special for students, and so what I've seen at my club is a sense of community, a sense of belonging at school, and I've also seen an inclusion of a variety of students. So it's amazing for me to think how things have changed so dramatically. It's all about nurturing humans, nurturing people, connecting with them. Technology may change over time, but that human connection is the number one thing that drives education.